Hi, it's Vicky here and welcome back. Today I have a fun video for you. I will be creating three different cards using the same stencil. This video is actually part of a fun blog hop as we celebrate the Sending Sunshine new release by Simon Says Stamp. Make sure to visit my blog because there is a giveaway there if you leave me a comment, and I also have a coupon code for you for a free gift. So for today's video, I will be using this gorgeous frame. This is called Leafy Frame. It's a lovely stencil and I'm planning to use it in three different ways just to give you a few ideas on how you can make the most out of your stencils. So for my first card, I have a piece of white cardstock. This is 4.25 by 5.5 and I'm securing it with some purple tape. I'm going to apply three different stress oxide inks. I'm using my blending tools to do so, and I'm not moving very fast as I go all around the frame, just because it is very easy to lift all those leaves and add ink underneath. So if you want to have a neat and a perfect result, which is not so easy, then you need to go slowly and press with your fingers down. Now, another way is to use some repositionable spray on one side of the stencil, and this way you will make sure that everything is nicely secured on top of your panel. But I didn't bother to do that for this card. Now I'm moving to my second color, which is Spiced Marmalade, and I'm going to apply it from the edges towards the center without touching the center at all, so I will have a lighter spot in the middle of my card. And finally, I'm going to finish off the background by adding some candy table only at the very edge of my card, so this way I am framing it nicely. And before I remove the stencil, I'm going to add some water splashes with my brush there, and I'm going to leave those to react with distress oxide ink for a few seconds, and then I'm going to blot them off and get a lovely textured effect. And finally, I can peel off the stencil and take a look at the result. I was really happy with the outcome, so let's turn this into a card. In the new release, there is this die that cuts out "You are my sunshine," but I chose to use only the word sunshine, and I have cut it out from white cardstock four different times. I have stacked one word on top of the other, so I get a lovely dimension there. And I'm going to finish off my sentiment by stamping "You are my" with black ink. So I can now add some glue at the back of my sentiment and stick it on top of my card. And hopefully you can see all the dimension that I have on my sentiment and how it stands out. Now I'm also going to add some white nouveau drops all over and around the leaves, and these are not going to turn out white because I have distress oxide ink underneath, which is going to react with these nouveau dots, and it's going to color them, which is exactly what I want, a really subtle look. Now, I'm also going to use nouveau drops to add the dot on my eye from the word sunshine, and then I'm going to add some foam tape at the back and stick that on top of a standard card. And this completes the first card for today, using inking and blending directly on the background, and of course you can use any types of ink that you have instead of using distress oxide inks. Now for my second card, I need to make sure that the stencil lays nicely on top of my panel. So I am using some Tombow Mono at the back, and I'm just applying it with my fingers there. When Tombow Mono dries, it becomes repositionable, which is going to make my stencil sticky on one side. And of course you can use repositionable spray if you have that. So now I can apply my stencil on top of my panel, and I don't want to have on the sides any stenciling, so I'm going to put them at the back, and I end up having a border only at the top and at the bottom. I'm going to place my card inside the box, and now I'm going to use some sprays. These are the Dilutions Shimmer Sprays, and I'm actually using Pure Sunshine and Fresh Lime. I'm going to spray with the green one towards the top, and I like that I get a fine mist as well as little dots, and at the bottom I'm going to use the Pure Sunshine. Now, as much as I love the look of sprays, I really hate the mess that they make, so I always have a box close by, and if I need to spray something I will just do it there. Now I'm going to lift off the stencil and see the result. and I think it looks amazing. So here is a close-up look on this background, and hopefully you can see the shine from the shimmer sprays. Now I'm going to turn this into a card, so I'm adding a very thin strip of gold paper on one side, and I'm going to add some foam tape at the back of this panel and stick it directly on top of a standard card size. Now for the sentiment, I went with a die cut that says "You," and this comes from an older release by Simon Says stamp. I'm going to stick that on top of my card base, and I'm going to finish off the sentiment by stamping "Are the best" underneath. Now this card is so shiny in real life, but so hard to catch in a photo. However, hopefully you can see how shiny it is here. Now for the next card, I am using a piece of white cardstock. I have placed my stencil on top and secured it nicely. And now with a spatula, I'm going to apply my paste. This is actually Nuvo Glimmer Paste in a lovely blue color. It looks that I am applying the paste really quickly, but I don't. This is in fast forward, so I made sure that I went slowly so that I don't lift any of those leaves. I'm using my paper trimmer to cut off just one strip of paper with that glimmer paste and the lovely impression. And actually glimmer paste dries quite quickly, of course depending on how thick you have applied it. And I have here a thin strip of silver mirrored cardstock. This is a product by Tonic Studios. I'm going to stick this on one side of my little panel there. And now I'm going to stick this panel on top of my card base by using foam tape at the back. All of these cards have a really versatile design, so depending on the occasion, you can stamp any sentiment. In this case, I went with a silver die cut that says "Hello." This is an older die by Simon Says Stamp, and my card is finished. And here are the three cards using inks, sprays, and glimmer paste over the same stencil. Always remember to place your stencil in different positions to get different looks. So these were the cards for today. I hope you had fun and you got inspired. Here are some close-up photos on all of them. Don't forget this is part of a blog hop. There is a giveaway and a coupon code waiting for you on my blog. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you all next time.